Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about the sulfur containing amino acids and the branched chain amino acids. So there are three major sulfur containing amino acids, that is methionine, cysteine and cystine. So if you look at this methionine structure, it has a sulfur atom which is sandwiched between two carbons. This is called as the thioether linkage. Methionine is an essential amino acid and it is useful for synthesis of cystine. Methionine is also important for initiation of protein biosynthesis. So it is an important, it is helping in initiating protein biosynthesis. Now, what is this structure? Here we can see a central alpha carbon which is connected to a carboxyl and amino group, a hydrogen, and the R group is CH2OH. If you look at the R group of cystine and you look at the carbon skeleton, it is all same except that instead of SH of cystine, it has this OH or hydroxyl group. This is the structure of serine. And the structure is so similar because the entire carbon skeleton of cystine is derived from serine. So serine is very important for biosynthesis of cystine. This SH, also called as thiol group, comes from methionine. So methionine is an essential amino acid which is responsible for cystine biosynthesis, but the entire carbon skeleton of cystine comes from serine. Two molecules of cystine can undergo oxidation to form a strong disulfide bond between the two thiol groups. This is called as cystine, and it is seen in various proteins like immunoglobulins and insulin. The sulfur containing amino acids are almost an exclusive dietary source of sulfur to the body. Cystine is also useful in synthesis of taurine, which is required for bile acids, coenzyme A, which takes part in various reactions in the body, and for glutathione, which is responsible for the integrity of the RBC membrane and also helps to destroy free radicals in the body. So this, the what is the name of glutathione? It's actually gamma glutamyl cystinyl glycine. So it requires cystine for its synthesis. So coming on to the metabolism of the sulfur containing amino acids, the first reaction is conversion of methionine to SAM or S-adenosyl methionine to form S-adenosyl homocystine. Methionine to SAM or S-adenosyl methionine occurs with the help of enzyme MAT, methionine adenosyl transferase, which has three isoforms. MAT 1 and 3 are found in liver, whereas MAT 2 occurs in the extrahepatic tissue. This enzyme requires ATP and cofactor magnesium. S-adenosyl methionine forms S-adenosyl homocysteine or SAH by donating its methyl group. S-adenosyl methionine is the methyl donor of the body. This occurs with the help of transmethylation reactions which occur throughout the body. The methyl group is accepted by an acceptor of the methyl group to form a methylated compound. For example, norepinephrine forms epinephrine, Ethanolamine forms choline. Carnosine, which is a beta-alanyl dipeptide, forms anserin. And acetyl serotonin forms melatonin, which is important in the serotonin pathway of tryptophan. Guanidinoacetate forms creatinine. Transmethylation reactions all require S-adenosylmethionine as the methyl donor. SAH is then converted to homocysteine with the help of adenosyl homocystinase. This homocysteine can now undergo two fates. One is the synthesis of cystine, and the second one is regeneration of methionine. Regeneration of methionine occurs with the help of homocysteine methyl transferase enzyme, which requires N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate and vitamin B12. This reaction is very, very important in one carbon metabolism. The second fate of homocysteine is to form cystine with the help of transsulfuration reaction. This reaction requires coenzyme pyridoxal phosphate. Homocysteine forms cystathionine by incorporation of serine in the presence of enzyme cystathionine beta synthase. The cystathionine then undergoes degradation to form cystine in the presence of enzyme cystathioninase. Both of them require PLP as a coenzyme. And you can see here that there is release of α-ketobutyrate, which forms propionyl-CoA. This then forms succinyl-CoA to enter the TCA cycle. Hence, all sulfur-containing amino acids are glycogenic. Deficiency of either cystathionine beta synthase or homocysteine methyl transferase. Both can result in homocystinemia. Because if either of these steps are blocked, it will lead to elevated levels of homocysteine in the blood. This is associated with increased risk of stroke, thromboembolism, and cardiovascular disease. So in cystine, I have said it occurs with the help of transsulfuration reaction, and the whole carbon skeleton is derived from serine, which is incorporated with the help of cystathionine beta synthase. Only the SH group comes from methionine. So coming to homocystinuria or homocystinemia, four types of homocystinuria occur. Type 1 is due to deficiency of cystathionine synthase. It presents similar to Marfan syndrome. Type 2 is because of deficiency of N5N10 methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase. 3 is due to deficiency of N5N10 methyl tetrahydrofolate homocysteine methyl transferase. Type 4 is because of N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate homocysteine methyl transferase. Increased homocysteine in the blood is associated with cardiovascular disease, DVT, thromboembolism, and stroke. There may be scoliosis, high arched palate, and generalized osteoporosis, which may make the doctor confused as to whether this is Marfan syndrome. But if you see, then in homocystinuria, there will be dislocation of the lens, which is downward and inward. Lens dislocation also occurs in Marfan syndrome, but in that case it will be outward and upward. The patient may have mental retardation and there will be elevated levels of homocysteine in the urine. Another inborn error of metabolism seen in sulfur-containing amino acid disorders is cystinuria. In cystinuria, there is increased urinary levels of four amino acids, that is cysteine, ornithine, arginine, and lysine. This occurs because of defective carrier system in the kidney, which is responsible for renal reabsorption of these amino acids. The second one, another inborn error of metabolism seen as cystinosis. It is because of a lysosomal defect in which there is increased levels of cystine crystals which are deposited in the reticuloendothelial system. So, cystine accumulates in the lysosomes of various tissues, resulting in impairment of renal function. The patient usually dies due to renal failure by nearly 10 years after onset of disease. So this finishes the inborn errors of metabolism seen in sulfur-containing amino acids. Coming on to one of the main special products of sulfur-containing amino acids, polyamines. They are organic compounds with multiple amino groups, useful for cell growth and to stabilize intact cell membranes and organelles. They also act as growth factors. Synthesis of polyamines occurs when ornithine decarboxylase acts on ornithine to form putrescine. This putrescine then forms spermidine with the help of spermidine synthase, which requires decarboxylated S-adenosyl methionine to form MTA or methyl thioadenosine. Spermidine then forms spermine with the help of spermine synthase, which also requires decarboxylated SAM. Putrescine, spermidine and spermine are the most common and most important polyamines. So now we will start the branched chain amino acids. Valine, leucine and isoleucine are all essential amino acids. Valine is glycogenic, whereas leucine is the only purely ketogenic amino acid. Isoleucine is both glycogenic as well as ketogenic. The first three metabolic reactions are common to the branched chain amino acids. The first one is a transamination reaction with the help of enzyme branched chain amino acid transaminase. Isoleucine forms α-keto beta-methyl glutarate, valine forms α-keto isovalerate, and leucine forms α-keto isocaptorate. The second reaction is oxidative decarboxylation. This occurs with the help of an enzyme BCKD, which is branched chain keto acid dehydrogenase enzyme. It requires various cofactors like thymine, pyrophosphate, FAD, NAD, lipomide, and coenzyme A. So, in isoleucine, it forms alpha methyl butyryl CoA, valine forms isobutyryl CoA, and leucine forms isovaleryl coenzyme A. The final step is dehydrogenation reaction. This is the last common metabolic step which occurs. The dehydrogenation is very similar to that seen in fatty acid oxidation and it requires FAD as the coenzyme. Then the metabolism of branched chain amino acids diverges and takes independent routes. In a series of reactions, isoleucine forms propionyl-CoA and acetyl-CoA. Valine forms propionyl-CoA and leucine ultimately forms acetoacetate and acetyl-CoA, which can take part in fat synthesis. Deficiency of BCKD enzyme results in defect in oxidative decarboxylation. This results in maple syrup urine disease. In this disease, there will be accumulation of branched chain amino acids and their keto acids. resulting in impairment in transport and function of other amino acids. This reduces protein biosynthesis and also inhibits enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase. This enzyme is very important for oxidative deamination, which is useful in urea biosynthesis. The branched chain amino acids competitively inhibit this enzyme. The disease results in acidosis, lethargy, convulsions, mental retardation, coma, and finally death within 1 year after birth. To diagnose this condition, we measure the serum and urine values of the branched chain amino acids and their keto acids. In the plasma, in addition to elevated levels of the branched chain amino acids, we will also see elevated levels of alloisoleucine. The keto acids are detected by DNPH test, which is dinitrophenylhydrazine test. Ruthera's test may be done, and enzyme analysis in leukocytes and cultured fibroblasts is very specific for detection of the disease. The treatment consists of dietary restriction of valine, leucine, and isoleucine, and some patients respond to high doses of thymine. In severe cases, liver transplantation may be required. Now, we already said that the ketogenic amino acids will form propionyl-CoA, which then enters the TCA cycle by getting converted to succinyl-CoA. This occurs in two steps. First, the propionyl-CoA is converted to methylmalonyl-CoA with the help of propionyl-CoA carboxylase enzyme. This requires biotin. Methylmalonyl-CoA then converts into succinyl-CoA with the help of a mutase enzyme, which requires another vitamin B, which is vitamin B12. In case of vitamin B12 deficiency, this step cannot occur, and this results in elevated methylmalonyl-CoA levels in the blood, which is then excreted in the urine, resulting in methylmalonic aciduria. This helps to differentiate vitamin B12 deficiency from folic acid deficiency, because even though in both we see megaloblastic anemia and homocystinuria, methylmalonic aciduria is seen exclusively in B12 deficiency. Deficiency of either of these two enzymes will result in neonatal ketoacidosis, because keto acids produced from the branched chain amino acids cannot be metabolized. So a diet low in protein or a diet which is low in the branched chain amino acids is recommended. This finishes sulfur containing amino acids and the branched chain amino acids. Quick recap of sulfur containing amino acids. Methionine forms SAM, which takes part in transmethylation reactions and is the principal methyl donor of the body. Forms SAH in the process of transmethylation, which then forms homocysteine. This homocysteine can undergo two pathways. One is the regeneration of methionine with the help of homocysteine methyl transferase, which requires N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate and vitamin B12. This reaction takes a very important part in 1-carbon metabolism. And the other is the synthesis of cystine. Cystine is formed via transsulfuration reactions with incorporation of serine. Deficiency of enzyme cystathionine synthase or homocysteine methyl transferase will result in homocystinuria, which may present with Marfan-like habitus and has to be differentiated by examining the lens dislocation, which in homocystinuria is inward and downward. Valine, leucine, and isoleucine can cause branched chain keto acids to form, and these keto acids then undergo oxidative decarboxylation reaction with the help of BCKD enzyme. If there is deficiency of this, it results in maple syrup urine disease, in which the urine has odor of maple syrup because of elevated keto acids in the urine. The patient may have mental retardation and ultimately dies by 1 year of age. So this finishes the lecture. Thanks for watching, and if you like the video, then please like, share, and subscribe.